We have Rob Shooter here with us.
Rob Shooter.
You know, Rob Shooter likes to do, you know, the entertainment, the celebrities, but he can talk a little politics, too.
You want to talk politics?
We can talk politics. Hello, both.
Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Well, let's put up the pictures of Christine Quinn again, making a pie in her kitchen. I mean, you know, the New York Times, everybody else there investigating, you know what I mean? They're going through their garbage, literally. This is the kind of coverage.
Wow.
Yeah, this is a profile of her summer home in New Jersey.
Wow.
And, I mean, I don't really blame Quinn. I blame the Times. What? What are they thinking? What happened to the folks who, you know, received the Pentagon Papers?
But you know what? You can't have one bad story after another.
How
you
about
need
this?
To have
it's
something
a very else. Nice place. She, has.
She has gotten. I mean,
very
and I.
Nice.
She has gotten an absurd number of puff piece stories. And Rosanna, you noticed this.
Yes.
Rob, have you?
Yeah, she's the darling of the press at the moment. But I think I heard you say earlier, they do build you up and it's a long way to fall. So if all she's used to is these lovely, lovely puff pieces, what's going to happen when somebody asks her a really tough question?
She gets asked the tough questions and she handles them, but it's more of a media story than a political story. Like, what is it about their fascination
right.
with this?
Do you think it's because she's a lady? Sometimes people say that, like, Hillary might have got it easier than a man might
have. She's not the first woman to run. Now, she's the first openly gay woman to run.
Right.
But not the first woman to run for mayor.
Mm. Yeah. I can't explain it. I actually lived in the same building as the speaker for a while.
And?
It was amazing to see her pull up with
them. Was she a good neighbor?
She's a very, like a good neighbor. State Farm is there. She was a very, very sweet neighbor. She did have a lot of security around her, though. It's amazing living in a building with someone that's that high profile. But, good neighbor. Put her trash out. Recycled.
All right, there you go.
Okay.
So she's good.
All
she's
right.
good. Now let's get down to Rob's comfort zone here.
Yes,
can we talk a little bit, Justin Bieber?
Bieber's in a lot of trouble. He's been in London for a couple of weeks doing concerts. He got into a terrible fight with the paparazzi over there. They're notoriously aggressive in Britain. However, he fought back, screamed at them, which they loved because they caught that on video. Then he actually ended up in hospital in London after one of his concerts.
We saw that. We saw the picture. And very narrow young man.
Yeah, sweated, no
yes.
shirt and everything.
Bizarre.
Yeah.
But maybe not that ill, because the next day he did another concert in London, and then unfortunately he's just cancelled a concert in Portugal. His manager is saying there's logistic problems. People are telling me that nobody was buying tickets.
Well,
interesting.
Well, you know, a couple of years ago we were like, ah, Justin Bieber, you know, Justin Bieber who, you know, like no, seriously, like, oh, he's just some teen, whatever. This kid is a genius.
He's talented.
And
very much so.
Elvis Presley kind of talent.
Yeah, I mean, he really, really knows what he's doing. What's going to bring him down, if anything is, and we've seen this a lot with Miley Cyrus and maybe Britney Spears. It's really hard being that famous, that young, and being out there by yourself. Like, he's not there with his mom, his manager's here in America, so they sent him to Britain to make all this money without any maybe support.
You know what you forget too is that these people are on the road a lot. It's not easy.
It's brutal.
And then you're there and you got to do promotion and you know
what's
glamorous.
You know
it's not that glamorous. It's hard work, time and energy.
Guess what? So is third period algebra.
That is,
all right.
You're right.
There
you're
are
right.
a lot of advantages to be life on the road and not having to deal with the drudgery and pain of high school.
It's
you remember
true.
That?
It's true.
You may have been you were popular.
No, but I'm just saying. You know, it looks easy, but, you know, it's
I went
it's
on the road
life.
For a little bit with Bon Jovi. I worked for Bon Jovi for a bit. The hardest thing about being on the road when you're that successful is when you finish your show and you're pumped of adrenaline and you feel great, you go back to an empty hotel room and sit by yourself. Mm. And that's when a lot of them get in trouble.
Are you kidding me? They go back to the hotel room and they trash it. I've seen the videos. They invite people over, groupies, and that's where the problem
Justin
starts.
Justin is by himself, so in a bit of trouble. And now these ticket sales are worrying people, but they're not selling in Portugal.
You'll be impressed. I noticed a gossip item over the weekend.
What happened?
What's her name? Hannah Montana.
Hannah Montana.
Miley Cyrus.
Miley Cyrus is no longer engaged, or at least no longer wearing a wedding ring, engagement ring, to the guy from the Hunger Games movie.
That is true. She is fighting back, saying those rumors are not true, that they are together.
Yeah, but that guy was seen hooking up with a woman from
Look at you!
Jeffrey Jones was out with him. like, you know, having a drink. They say they were not hooking up. They say they were having a fun night out together.
She was out so loud and, oh, you're so handsome and that kind of thing, and then they went off alone. Something happened.
I don't know.
He studied that.
I don't know.
Was it the Globe, the Inquirer, Storm
Magazine? It was the Oscars.
They definitely were out together. They did go out together. I don't think anything happened, although Miley is now walking around without the engagement ring. She is saying that they're still engaged and there will be a wedding.
That's the first sign. There's trouble.
Can we talk about Justin Timberlake? He was in town. Well, actually, he's in town all week.
He was.
What's going on with him? He's doing, like, just every show.
Yeah, I mean, he's out there promoting this new album. He's coming back to music after a long break. He wants to be the king again. He doesn't want to come back to music and not have a hit. So he did Saturday Night Live here. This is what a good guy he is. People queue up overnight to try and get standby tickets. He sent pizza down to everybody, lining up around 30.
That's nice.
What a humanitarian.
That's nice.
This looks just like what he did at the Oscars, by the way.
It is very similar. This is his whole new look.
Let's turn it up. Is it good? Let me hear it.
It's great.
Bring sexy back.
Sexy back's a good song.
Yeah.
But what I like about this song, I like that whole Sinatra, Michael Bublé type look. I like the big band behind him. It's kind of retro.
It's a little nostalgic.
Yeah, and then he had a dig in the song to Kanye West, who dished him.
What's going on with Kanye?
Kanye doesn't like these songs, so Kanye was saying this wasn't a great song, so he had another dig back in the song to Kanye.
What did he say?
He said, like, I'm sorry that my bleep is so hot that it's upsetting rappers.
His what is so hot?
His beep.
Oh. I thought you meant bleep, like bad word.
It was a bad word.
Oh. It was a word.
Mm-hmm.
Write it down. I'll tell you, sometimes the Brits, you know, what they think is a bad word isn't necessarily what we think is a bad word.
S-H-I.
No, no, you can't say that.
I can't even read it.
It's number two.
All right. Rob, anything else on your mind?
What else is going on? Oh, Justin's hair's the big controversy, too.
Ooh.
Justin Timberlake used to have curly hair. Remember when he was in
the
boy band?
Did he have keratin?
I think he's flat ironing his hair.
Oh, my gosh. You can do better than that.
This is breaking news.
Anne Hathaway, doesn't count.
Anne Hathaway's doing another musical.
Good for her.
My Fair Lady.
Come on.
In talks to do My Fair Lady.
Okay,
sing it again.
Okay, this is good.
We like that?
We like that.
Reach down and say the stuff that you tell us off air. That's so much better than some of the stuff you say on air.
We want him to come back again.
That is so tame. Ooh, Justin Timberlake changes his hairdo after 10 years.
That's big news. Hair's a big deal. If you notice now, every time he's outside and it's raining, a little damp, wears a hat.
Hey, Rob Shooter, thank you for coming. We are deeply disappointed. I'm only teasing. Come on, good
that
stuff.
That was a lot of fun. Thank you. But I was wondering about his hair. I bet
Thank you.
Audrey.
I'm worried about
keratin treatment.
Sequestration.
I love his hair. His hair looks fabulous. Almost as fabulous as Rob Shooter's hair.
There you go.
I mean, that's a good head of hair right there.
That's a good head.
Well, Rob, if anybody wants to read your scoop, where
can
they go?
To naughtybutnicerob.com. I've left the Huffington Post and started up my own website.
Naughtybutnice.com.
Naughtybutnicerob.com.
Very cool.
Very nice. Congratulations.
Jeep Grand Cherokee, with its best-in-class driving range of up to